faced many enemies in my life, but none as dangerous as the Venom Symbiote. It's a living organism that bonds with its host, enhancing their strength, speed, and aggression. It also feeds on their negative emotions, making them more violent and unstable. It can shape-shift, camouflage, and create weapons from its own body. It can also influence the host's mind, making them more susceptible to its will. The symbiote has bonded with several people over the years. As soon as bonding process completes, they become a threat to the entire world, sooner or later, and they must be stopped. I make contingencies because I've seen the toll it takes on those who succumb to its influence. Venom amplifies strength, but at the cost of sanity and control. If it were to let loose in this world, chaos would reign. People would become uncontrollable beasts, tearing through the fabric of society, leaving nothing but destruction in their wake. Imagine the streets of Gotham transformed into a battleground, with venom-fueled individuals wreaking havoc on the city. Innocent lives would be at stake, and chaos would become an unstoppable force. I can't allow that to happen. That's why I've developed a contingency plan for the Venom Symbiote, in case it ever tries to bond with me or anyone else. I need to use my gadgets and skills to fight them off. Venom bonded with a host is stronger and faster than me, but I have the advantage of intelligence and strategy. I'll use my batarangs equipped with micro-incinerators, grappling gun to keep my distance from Venom, smoke pellets for distraction, and electric shock darts and sonic emitters to keep him at bay. I'll still avoid direct contact with the symbiote at all costs, as it can infect me and take over my mind. I have also upgraded my armor with high-frequency emitters and small gas-based flame generators to repel Venom from my armor. I'll also isolate him from any potential allies or victims. The symbiote thrives on conflict and chaos, so it will seek out targets that can either help or harm it. The best way to prevent this is to trap the host in a secure location, preferably with no access to communication or transportation. I've prepared several such locations in Gotham, such as the Batcave, Wayne Mansion, and Gotham Golf Park. The symbiote is vulnerable to certain frequencies of sound and heat, which can cause it pain and force it to detach from the host. I've designed several devices that can emit these frequencies, such as sonic batarangs, thermal grenades, and a modified Batmobile. I've also synthesized a chemical compound that can disrupt the symbiote's molecular structure, making it easier to separate from the host. I've loaded this compound into my utility belt, as well as into several dart guns and spray cans. Once the symbiote is detached from the host, it will try to escape or find a new host. It can move very fast and blend into any environment, making it hard to track and catch. I've developed a special containment unit that can hold the symbiote securely, using a combination of sound-emitting electronics, vacuum seals, and liquid nitrogen. The unit is portable and can be activated remotely, allowing me to capture the symbiote from a safe distance. In unlikely event Venom manages to go past these contingency plans, I have also packed a neurotoxic agent to neutralize Venom along with me. This drastic step is to ensure my body doesn't bond with Venom symbiote and cause any loss of life. As soon as I trigger this neurotoxin integrated in my armor, it will also alert Bat family of my demise and provide them with pre-recorded messages, my coordinates, and my contingencies so the hunt continues even without me. They'll have every strategical advantage when dealing with Venom. Even if it costs me my life, Bill won't let anything happen to citizens of Gotham. Because I am vengeance. I am the Knight. I am Batman.